Hey guys, what's up? So today, we are looking at how to draw the front and back flat sketches of a basic kurti. As always, these are the important keyboard shortcuts for today's illustration. So write them down somewhere and let's get started. So on a fresh A4 size artboard, I'm gonna start by drawing out just the left half of my kurti. But before that, I'm gonna turn on Smart Guides by going to View and Smart Guides. Now the benefit of turning Smart Guides on is, you see this pink vertical line appearing here? That indicates the exact center of this artboard. So I'm gonna begin drawing the left half of my kurti by starting here. This is the neckline, the armhole area, the side seam, and now that I am at the hem to finish off the left half, when I bring my mouse here, the pink vertical line once again appears to show me that if I end my line here, it's perfectly aligned with this point on my neckline. So I'm going to put a point here, and then here. And that is why smart guides are important, guys. Next, I'm going to draw out the sleeve. For this, I'm choosing the direct selection tool and I'm going to highlight just this line. Then I'm going to hit the shortcuts Command C and Command F on my keyboard to create a copy that will end up falling exactly over the original. As you can see, the copy is now here indicated in blue. Now hit P on your keyboard to bring up the pen tool, and I'm going to draw out the sleeve by connecting my pen tool to this blue line. Let's take it down. And yep, that looks good. Now the front parts of the kurti are ready, so let's draw the backs. I'm going to start at the sleeve hem. This time as well, I'm going to use my direct selection tool to first highlight just this line. Then using the shortcuts Command C and Command F, I have made a copy of just this line and it is placed exactly over the original. Once again, as you can see, it is highlighted in blue. Then back on the pen tool, I'm going to draw the inner back of the sleeve like so. Now I'm going to draw the inner back of the kurti's body. So highlight the body, but this time I'm going to use the shortcuts Command C and Command B. So that the copy created will be placed exactly behind the original. Once the copy is made, I'm using my direct selection tool to click this point and then use my up arrow key to move this point up as the back neckline needs to be higher. I'm also making an adjustment to the handle here. After this, I'm going to go to the hem and in a similar way, I'm modifying it to stretch out a bit more to the bottom and to the sides. So now it looks like a kurti which has slits at the side. The left half is done. The next step is to reflect a copy onto the right side. For this, I'm going to first highlight everything, then click O because that is the shortcut for the reflect tool. You can also see it get selected here. Then while holding down Option, I'm going to come here and click on this anchor point at the very top. Now I'm clicking here because I want this point to be the center between both halves of my kurti. And when I click, this table opens up. Now all you have to do is hit copy and your right side has been perfectly reflected and placed as well. Next, I'm going to select both front halves like so, open the Pathfinder tool and hit Unite. Hitting Unite will join both halves into one. I'm also going to do the same for the inner back's halves. When that is done, I'm going to stop and take a look at the whole thing overall. Does it look realistic? Does it look proportionate? Etc. For me, I want to zoom into the neckline and correct this area here because it's looking a bit more pointy than round. So I'm going to click this point and you see this tiny circle that shows up? Simply click and drag that upwards and the neck has rounded out. I'm also going to bring the front neck a bit lower by clicking on these two points. Then I'm going to drag the points down using the downward arrow key on my keyboard. I'm also going to take the back neck a bit higher using the same technique. And this looks good to me, so I'm going to stop there and move on to adding stitches. For this, right-click on the front bodice and select Isolate Selected Path. Doing this will gray out every other shape on your board, and you can now draw on or manipulate this one shape without disturbing anything else on your board. So let's start with the stitch lines for this shape. Beginning at the hem, I'm going to select just this one line here. Then on my keyboard, I'm going to hit Command C and Command F to create a copy. Now I'm going to use the upward arrow key to move it upwards and place it like this. Now with it highlighted, open the stroke panel and select dashed line. These are the settings here. Dash is the length of your stitch and gap is the length of the gap between your stitches. I'm going to change it to 3 and 1 respectively and then close the stroke panel. Next, I'm going to adjust the corners of the line as it is coming out of the kurti border by a little bit. This line also has a white fill if you see here, so I'm also removing that. Now create a copy of the line and place it below so that it ends up becoming a double needle stitch line. I'm also going to draw in stitch lines at the side slit here and reflect that onto the right. And for the neck, in a similar manner, I'm going to first highlight just this curved line, then make a copy using Command C and Command F, move the copy downwards with the arrow keys, and this time I'm going to select the eyedropper tool, and with it I'm going to touch an existing stitch line on my board. Now the eyedropper tool's function is to convert any highlighted line into anything that it touches. So as you can see, this line has also become a stitch line. Now place it properly, adjust the corners and the stitches, and the front of the kurti's body is done. Now this whole time we have been in isolation mode, so to come out of it, simply double click on anywhere else outside of this artwork. Next, I'm going to go to the inner back of the kurti, and the exact same way, I'm going to add stitch lines to that as well. Now for the sleeves, you can simply draw a double needle stitch line since this is such a small area. When done, reflect it onto the right side and the sleeves are done. All the stitch lines are now done, guys. My next step is to highlight all the inner backs and color them gray, just so that we have a differentiation between the front and the back. I also want to give the entire kurti a thick black outline. So for this, I'm going to use my group selection tool to highlight every shape that is forming the main outline of the kurti. So that will be the inner back and the front and backs of the sleeves. Hold down shift while selecting so that you can select multiple objects at once. Now, let's create a copy of all these shapes by hitting Command C and Command Shift V. This will place a copy of all these objects exactly over the original. Now, while it is still highlighted, open the Pathfinder tool and hit Unite. Next, increase the stroke width to about 8 and then right-click on the shape, go to Arrange and Send to Back. Now, as you can see, the kurti flat sketch is starting to get a more professional look. My next step is to start adding fold lines. So with my stroke back on one and in a black color, I'm drawing in lines with the pen tool like this. When you're done drawing one line, hit Escape to stop the line right there. You can now start the next line. Now copy and reflect these lines onto the right. Now that the lines are done, I'm going to go change the variable width profile of these lines. So start by selecting the lines that are touching the border first. Increase the stroke width, then come up here to the variable width profile and choose width profile 4. What this did is, it modified the lines to make them thinner at one end and thicker at the other. I'm also going to highlight these two lines which are not touching the border and change them into width profile 1 this time, which will basically make the line thinner at both ends and thick at the center. I'm gonna do the same thing to these two lines. And guys, with that, the flat sketch of the front of a kurti is done. So let's move to creating the back. Let's start by creating a new artboard by opening the artboard panel here and clicking on the plus icon. A new artboard has therefore appeared. Now quickly, let's go back to our previous sketch and group everything together. Let's make a copy of it and then bring it over to the new artboard. Now with the group selection tool, I'm going to highlight just the front body of my kurti along with all the stitch lines on it. Let me zoom in for you to have a closer look, and let's zoom out. I'm then going to hit delete and you should be left with this much. Now select the front of the kurti and simply hit D on your keyboard. Now D will automatically give any shape a white fill and a black outline. And already this flat sketch is starting to look like the back of the kurti. Now let's correct the sleeves. So I'm going to first select the stitch lines on the sleeve and then hit delete. Then with the direct selection tool, I'm going to select the front and the back of the sleeve, open up the pathfinder tool and hit unite. Now with the sleeves highlighted, once again hit D so that it gets a black stroke and a white fill. Next, I'm going to zoom in and modify the stitch lines like this. And this is what it will look like when it is done. I'm going to go to the same thing to the other sleeve. The next thing I'm going to do is come to the neckline and delete these two lines. When that is done, the final step for both the front and the back flat sketches is to highlight the main body parts, like the front sleeves and the front body, and increase the stroke of these to 2. This is just so that the main outlines are differentiated from the stitch lines and the fold lines. And with that, our basic kurti is done. Now you can stop here guys, but I'm gonna additionally show you how to add a bit of detail to the neck. We are gonna be changing this neck into this neck. So let's zoom in to the neckline. Now at the very center, I'm gonna create 3 new anchor points. So hit the plus key on your keyboard to bring up the Add Anchor Point tool, or you can simply choose it from the drop-down menu here. Then add 1 anchor point here, then here, and then here. Now switch to the Direct Selection tool, click on the center anchor point of these 3 and drag it downwards like so. I'm making a few more adjustments to it. Now this stitch line is running across here, so we need to remove that. For this, back on my Add Anchor Point tool, I'm adding a point here and here. Then select this extra piece at the center with the Direct Selection tool and simply hit Delete. The neckline is now perfect. Next, I'm going to draw a stitch line like this. And now I'm going to draw the loop and the button. So with the pen tool, draw a curvy line like so. Increase the stroke width. Then come up here to Object and Expand. With Fill and Stroke highlighted, hit OK. What that did is, it converted this line into a shape. Now hit D on your keyboard to automatically give this shape a black stroke and a white fill. Then let's zoom in and adjust the shape with the Direct Selection tool. Once the loop is done, copy and paste another loop below. Next, with the Ellipse tool, simply draw a circle like so, and copy and paste one below as well. Our kurti is now not so basic and it is also complete. So I'm hoping that was useful for you. Thank you for watching and I will see you all next week.